I think this is perfect timing. Maybe one of your New Year's resolutions was to travel more, and really, who wants to rough it when there are some affordable luxury destinations out there? Here with an overview of some of her favorite places to luxuriate for less, and I really like the way that sounds, Carol Parahudol. She's a luxury travel expert with Transat Holidays. Welcome. I'm glad you made it.
Thank you. I was worried there for a bit with the weather.
Yeah, well, I think people are starting to think about getting out of here right now. This is the time. And let's start with somewhere warm. Let's head to Mexico.
Right. Well, I think if you want affordable luxury down south, you should think about the all-inclusive.
Yes.
My husband and I did a Transat Holidays Luxury Collection package to the Gran Vela's Riviera Maya Resort.
Yes.
And there's so many extras included. We had private transfers to our hotel and VIP lounge access at the airport. And then once we got to the hotel, we could eat at any of the gourmet restaurants.
Right.
And the Gran Vela's is really known for its food. So this is so good because a lot of times I'll put all my money into staying at a top hotel. Mm-hmm. And then once I'm there, I can't really afford to do anything,
right.
You know, and swan around the lobby or have a drink. But I can't afford to have all my meals there.
You look good there, but you're not
fed. I'm here.
So. Okay, so these are all ways to sort of, you know, make yourself feel like you're living the high life, but not break the bank doing it.
Yeah, it takes the stress off your pocketbook and puts it right on your hips and thighs.
I'm all for that. All right, we're heading to Cuba next, to Varadero, very popular destination.
Yes, Cuba is such a great affordable destination for Canadians, and that might change in the future with the way politics are going, so mm-hmm. go now. I love Varadero for the beach, and Transat Holidays has a lot of different packages there, and whatever your budget, that beach is yours, you know, and that's a luxury in itself.
I agree, the ocean.
Yeah.
Wow, does that sound good right now? Next, we are going to travel to Ireland.
Love Ireland. What always surprises me is the affordability of the self-drive holiday.
Right.
And Transat Holidays does some packages with self-drive and B&Bs. My husband and I, before he was my husband, we drove down the southeastern coast of Ireland. And to me, this is the unsung hero of Ireland.
Mm-hmm.
It's very atmospheric and peaceful. And the number one activity has to be hiking along that stunning coastline, and that's free.
And a lot of Calgarians into that in our own backyard. So this is a way to do it somewhere completely different.
Yes.
Next, I've heard so much about Prague, and I would love to go.
Prague is so atmospheric for sightseeing. It is, it's like being in a museum with mm-hmm. beer.
Well, you had me there.
I spent 2 summers there studying writing, so I know it pretty well. But I have to say my favorite destinations in the Czech Republic for affordability and luxury are the spa towns of Karlovy Vary and Mariánské Lázně. Hard to say, but
yes.
Easy to visit. The spa towns there are much cheaper than a spa would be at home.
Okay, absolutely stunning photographs. And Nice, France. Nice is nice.
Nice is so close to my heart. I spend as much time as I can there, which isn't all that much. But I went to the Cannes Film Festival for mm-hmm. the first time last year, and that's so fun. And I found that staying in Nice, it's a great base for exploring the area, like mm-hmm. Monaco and Antibes and Grasse. But it's actually very reasonable to rent an apartment there. There's
right.
a lot of competition. And if you get, my one travel tip here is use the local train. It's fast, it's efficient, and get a pass for a local weekly pass. You pick the 2 towns farthest apart and you buy a pass for those 2 destinations.
Smart.
So for the week you can go anywhere and it's a fraction of what you pay for a daily ticket.
Incredible coastline to explore there.
Yeah.
And last but certainly not least, the very romantic Venice.
Oh, Venice. Yes, yeah, so romantic and not affordable.
Okay.
So sad. Everyone wants to go there because George Clooney and Amal got married there.
Right.
And much less famously, my husband and I had our honeymoon there.
And second only to
yeah,
George and Amal.
Since we didn't have his budget, I mean, who does? Maybe Brad Pitt, but not us. We compromised. We stayed 3 nights at the fantastic Greedy Palace Hotel, restored palace, beautiful. And another week at an apartment rental.
Right.
I think luxury travel is about balance,
mm-hmm.
especially if you want it affordable. You don't need the best of the best all the time. You know, it should enhance the trip you want to do rather than dictate it. So choose choose what you want, you know.
Carol, these are all fantastic options. It's transatholidays.com, and we'll put links and information on our website, breakfasttelevision.ca. All right, I've got the bug. Thank you so much for this. Good luck getting out of Calgary.